A very good morning, dear students. So far we have completed with the land of hot sun in the previous chapter. Today's class we are going to begin with the new chapter, that is natural resources. Resources which are available naturally in the nature, in our surroundings. In this chapter, what we are going to learn? In this chapter, we are going to learn about which are the resources available in the nature, in our day-to-day life. Then, types of natural resources and its classification. Then, how we are utilizing these natural resources. Then, can we use the any alternative uses instead of these resources? Then, what are the uses and how do we conserve? That is, how do we protect? How do we reduce in using the natural resources? All these we are going to study in the chapter, that is natural resources. So children, you could see at the picture which is shown in this video in your textbook, page number 53. You can observe carefully and identify what the early humans are doing. So in the picture A, one is having an hammer and the stone tool and is having a wood, log of wood. And another one in the right side in the B picture, they are working in the field and they are sowing the seeds to grow the crop. So both are involved in the usage of the resources which are available in nature. So what they might be doing? In the first picture, it tells us is converting the wood, raw wood, to some finished product or the tools. It might be a wheel or any other product out of wood. He is making something which will be used for the purpose. Next, in the B picture, it's telling about the two people are sowing the seeds in order to grow what? Crops. So in the nature, they are got the utilizing the resources from the nature and they are involved in the nature and they are getting all the resources from the nature which is available in the nature, and these resources are not made by or created by humans. Can we create these resources by the humans? No, certainly not. So we can say the resources which are available in our environment is called natural resources. Dear students, in the picture we saw the early humans was using the wood in the one picture and one was sowing the seeds in order to grow the crops in the field. So the early human is making wheel from a log of wood in the first picture, and the other picture we saw that planting seeds in the soil so for growing the crops. So soil is a natural resource or the man-made resources? It's a natural resources. So things such like air, soil, forest, minerals are what? They are the gift of nature. And earlier humans did not know how to use these resources. How to use this soil? How can we make use of the forest? And what is how the air will be used for breathing? Is it without air can we live or not? All those things they didn't knew. But over a period of time, after certain years, when they involved in the usage of these resources, they got to know the usage of these resources one by one. Next, they converted these things, the raw things which are available in the resources, to a useful things to satisfy their requirement. So it is then they came to know that it is one of the important, most important, valuable resources for them. Like forest, like sunlight. From the sun we get heat and light. Without heat, without light, can we survive? We will be in the dark. And rain. Without rain, can plants can grow? Can we drink water? No. Can we have the water to drink? Then buildings. These are the land on which we are settled. So dear students, we could say that the resources like sun, Then soil, forest, plants, animals, birds, water resources, and what else? Many resources are present in plenty in the nature. So we are also a part of the nature. So we can say the resources which are given by the nature as a gift to the man is called natural resources, which cannot be created by us. So again, when we come to the classification, generally the natural resources have been classified into two. One is renewable and another one is non-renewable. So natural resources we are using in plenty. Can we use to the till the end? No, some of them can be used for a smaller period of time. There are resources which cannot be used for more than once. Such kind of resources can be called it as non-renewable. So dear students, now let us see the meaning of renewable resources. Some natural resources do not exhaust it, like sunlight, soil, forest resources, water. These are the natural resources. As we use, it is not going to be exhausted. That means it will be present in plenty. We can use as much as possible for our needs. It is in large abundance. Abundance means plenty. And we can use these resources again and again. More than one time, 10 times, 15 times, more than once. Such resources are called renewable resources. Even though you are using for more than twice, thrice, it is not going to be finished, or it does not going to be empty. Heat provided by the sun, for example. Next, wind, that is air. Example of such resources. Plants and animals are also examples of living natural resources. So renewable resources is nothing but those resources which we can use again and again. Next is non-renewable resources. Renewable resource means using again and again, and if it is also available for more than twice, thrice, infinity. But non-renewable resources are those once used, it will be not available for the next time. It will get lost forever. So it will not get for the usage of one more time. So they will get exhausted over a period of time. Such resources are called non-renewable resources. It is not going to rebirth or reproduce. We cannot reproduce or regain a rebirth in the nature. Example, fossil fuels. Under fossil fuels, basically fossil fuels includes the old dry leaves, then skeletons, bones of the animals, and which will be decomposed in the soil for several years, then it is going to be converted into fossil fuels. So it takes many years to convert them into a fossil fuels like coal, petroleum, and natural gas. It takes millions of years to form, like leaves, old dead bodies, some other natural resources which are mixed with that, they convert them to fossil fuels. So therefore, these will be considered as non-renewable resources. In your textbook, it's given coal is used for generating electricity and cooking food. Coal is one such of minerals which will be getting on the earth. But once if you use, it will be not be regained again. You cannot get back the usage of that portion. That is coal. In order to get the coal, we required many years, they say. So we can say it's that natural resources are those resources which are available in the nature for the mankind. And renewable resources are those which can be used more again and again are called renewable resources. And non-renewable resources are those which will be exhausted if you use once. So dear students, in the next class we will be seeing about how you are going to use these natural resources. And what are the alternative resources which are available. We'll study in the next class. Along with this, I will be sending you the related reference video. Please go through that for your reference. Thank you.